Good afternoon, sir. It's a real pleasure that you have that we have you to talk to us about DRDO and DRDO's exhibits in Army 2021, Army Forum 2021. So for our international viewers, would you please elucidate something about DRDO?
See, DRDO is Defence Research and Development Organisation. It is the R&D wing of Ministry of Defence, Government of India. We are developing products related to military use in all the domains. So DRDO has 7 clusters. So missile systems, then aeronautical systems, then armament and combat engineering, electronics and communication systems, naval systems and materials, and then you have miniaturized devices cluster, and then life sciences cluster. So these 7 clusters combined together are fulfilling all the requirement of armed forces. DRDO now at present is working very closely with the industry and supporting industry also in a big way. And DRDO has good linkages with academy also. So combined together as a full strength of DRDO, we are able to develop products primarily for Indian Armed Forces and now which can be exported also. And then we have products which are in civilian use, which are spin-off technologies. DRDO has worked very hard during COVID times also as additional support to our society.
Sir, DRDO has come to Army 2021 with an array of exhibits. Can you please tell us more about your exhibits here?
In Army 2021, DRDO is displaying many products which are export ready. So you have fire control radar. Then you have Rohini radar, which is a surveillance radar, then LCA, then airborne early warning and control system, then ATAX, that is the longest range gun with DRDO, then Arjun tank Mark 1A is the next version of the Arjun tank Mark 1, which is our main battle tank. Then we have a carbine also on display, then IFF, that is identification of friend and foe. So that way DRDO has come up with many products. In addition to that, you have anti-tank guided missile, NAG, then another version of NAG, helicopter launched version, that is called Helena. So with these products, DRDO has come to interact with whoever may be interested. And as you know, the products are competing in its class with any other product in the world, and they are world-class technologies. They are at par in every technological aspect and cost competitive also.
Sir, during COVID times, DRDO did seem to have changed its way to reach its customers and the audience. Can you please tell us more about how you have changed yourselves during the tough times?
As you know, COVID times have been quite tough for anybody. However, DRDO laboratories have been working during COVID times also. We are able to now conduct meetings with all stakeholders in the video conferencing mode. Work-wise, DRDO has changed things in such a way that with COVID precautions, we are able to carry out even the missile testing and all the type of work. We are interacting with our international possible customers also, even through exhibitions conducting and attending the exhibitions, as well as through our website and social media. Now we have increased our presence very much. We are there on Twitter, we are there on Facebook, we are there on Instagram, and we have our website which gives details about large number of products. So that way, during COVID times, interaction with possible stakeholders as well as possible customers has not been less. It has been pretty good.
So have you felt that this has increased the popularity of DRDO lately?
During COVID times, DRDO did a lot of things for civilian sector. Like you know, the 2DG drug, DRDO set up hospitals also in a very, very short time. Then medical oxygen plants, around 866 plants are being set up. all across the country. Then we have oxygen air cylinders, so which has served the society in a big way. Moreover, people have seen that parallelly DRDO has done its core area of work also, that is developing the defense systems. So definitely it has impacted the public psychology in a positive way, and people now see DRDO not just as a defense R&D organization, but also organization capable of rising to any occasion which can be even remotely related to DRDO.
How has the private industries cooperating with DRDO?
Private industry is very much associated with DRDO, and they are very eager to associate. See, DRDO has a policy of DCPP, that is development cum production partner, where we choose industry right from beginning. Then DRDO has removed the fees for TOT in most of the cases and reduced in other cases. Our patents are available free of cost to private industry in most of the cases. Then DRDO is providing hand-holding in terms of testing available to them in DRDO places. And then many of the technologies have been transferred to the industry where DRDO is hand-holding for a pretty long time. Now for COVID-related technologies, all the DRDO labs have been authorized to transfer technology free of cost to any industry. So that way, industry at present is very, very eager to work with DRDO, and they have taken it very, very positively to realize the dream of Atmanirbhar Bharat as per the vision of our Prime Minister and as per the guidance of our Raksha Mantri. We are proceeding ahead to realize that vision. DRDO technologies are not only holding space of the world in defense sector, they are also supporting large number of public causes, as I told you about anti-COVID technologies.
Thank you very much.